So students, in this video, we are going to discuss about pediculosis. So it is a disease which is mainly caused in human head, all right? It is mainly caused in the region of head, in the human beings. And it is mainly caused by an ectoparasite called as Pediculus humanus, right? So there are two subspecies of Pediculus humanus which causes the disease called as pediculosis. So what are those two subspecies? Pediculus humanus capitis and another one is Pediculus humanus humanus. So these are the two different subspecies of Pediculus humanus which are responsible to cause pediculosis in the human beings. That is nothing but in the region of the head, right? And normally this Pediculus humanus capitis is commonly called as head louse, right? And Pediculus humanus humanus is commonly called as body louse, right? So this is just the introduction which I wanted to give you about this ectoparasite called as Pediculus humanus, which causes a disease called as pediculosis. So now let us discuss about the life cycle, which is mainly caused by this subspecies. And remember, both of the subspecies cause the same life cycle in the human beings. So how it is caused actually, let us see now. So coming to here, actually the life cycle will occur in three stages, right? So the life cycle occurs in three stages. So those three stages includes eggs, nymph and adults. So scientifically, these eggs are called as nids. So nids are the eggs which are laid by head louse or as a body louse, right? So now let us discuss about each of these stages. So coming to the first one about eggs. These eggs are laid by this head lice, which I have said you. And remember, we know that the eggs will be laid by the adult females itself. There are two individuals called as male individual as well as a female individual in this Pediculus humanus, right? And the female individual will lay the eggs. So coming to the size of those eggs, 0.8 millimeter in length and 0.3 millimeter in diameter. So this is size of the eggs, okay? And it is oval in shape, right? And the coming to the color of those eggs, yellow to white in color, right? It looks like yellow and some whitish in color, okay? And the normally the period of that egg without hatching is 1 week, right? And after 1 week, then the egg will get hatched such that the nymph will get protruded out from that egg, right? So now here the egg undergoes hatching after 1 week such that the nymphs will be released, right? So after hatching of the egg, the nymphs will be released from the egg. I mean, only from one egg, one nymph will be released, okay? So in that way, there are many eggs which will be laid, and now from those eggs, after hatching process, the nymphs will be released out. And normally those eggs, after releasing, then the shells will be present, right? The empty shells, and those empty shells will remain the color called dull yellow, right? It will remain in dull yellow in color, and it is mainly settled at hair shaft. Which one? The empty shells. After hatching, the nymphs will be released, right? Then the egg shell will be empty, and that empty shell will be dull yellow in color, and it will get settled in the hair shaft. And now these nymphs will undergoes maturation process to develop into adults, right? And this maturation process includes molting, right? So molting is the stages which is called as developmental stages. I mean, here totally three molting stages are involved such that the nymphs will get developed, will get matured to form adults, to get developed into adults, right? So within these three moltings, what will happen? Now let us see. Firstly, the egg will undergoes hatching, right? And then the nymphs will be released, and those are called as first nymphs. First nymph will be released out from that egg. And now this first nymph will undergo first molting. It will undergo first molting and will get developed into second nymph. And now the second nymph undergoes second molting and will get developed into third nymph. And now this third nymph will undergo third molting and will get developed into adults. Remember, these adults will also considered as male individual as well as a female individual. They contains male individual as well as a female individual. Appropriate individual will get protruded out, or else will get released out from the egg, and it will get developed and will get completely developed into adult. Either it may be a male or it's a female. Okay, so this is what molting stages occur. So totally three moltings will be done to get developed from nymph to the adult. So here, this is the first nymph, right? It undergoes first molting and get developed into second nymph. And this second nymph will undergo second molting and forms the third nymph. And this third nymph will undergo third molting and forms the adult. So totally three molting stages has been done to get developed the nymphs into the adult. So here the nymph will get developed into adult by three molting stages. So if you see in the diagrammatic form, so if you see here the structures, let us say this is the egg, right? And this egg undergoes hatching process, right? After hatching, after 1 week, I have said you, right? After 1 week, this egg will undergo hatching. After the egg gets hatches, then the first nymph will get released out from the egg. And now this first nymph will undergo first molting to form the second nymph. And the second nymph will undergo the second molting and forms the third nymph. Remember, the size will get increased, right? And now this third nymph will undergo third molting and will form the adults. So that adults contains male individuals as well, male individuals as well as the female individuals, right? So here the totally three moltings will be done such that the nymph will get completely developed into adults. So either it may be a male individual or else a female individual. So I have till now I have explained you about eggs as well as the nymph, right? So now let us discuss about the adults, the structure of the adults. And coming to these adults, the size remains like sesame seed. You know about sesame seeds, right? So in that particular size, these adults will be ranged, right? And here the female size will be big when compared to that of male. And this adult nymphs contains six legs, right? It contains six legs and they are grayish white in color. And the female adult individual will start laying 8 nids per day. Nids are nothing but the eggs. Here the scientific term they have given is nids, right? So these female adult individuals will lay 8 nids per day, right? And here the survival capacity of this parasite is 30 days, right? Is 30 days when it is present in the person's head, right? When it is present in the host head or else, right? And here it can survive for 30 days only when it feeds upon the blood meal of the host. I mean here we are going to discuss about the human beings, right? So if this parasite will feed upon the blood meal of that human beings, then it can survive for 30 days. And if it doesn't take blood meal, then it will die in 1 to 2 days itself. Then its survival capacity will be 1 to 2 days itself. And now coming to the transmission, here this parasite can be transmitted from one person to another person by using similar towels, combs, beds, pillows, carpets, head ribbons and etc. So these are the type of things which you are going to use similarly, common for both the individuals, then it can be transmitted from one person to another person easily. So among all of these things, here the combs as well as the bed plays a major and vital role which has higher probability of chances to get passed from one individual to another individual, or else to get transmitted from one individual to another individual. So this is a disease which is mainly caused in a person called as pediculosis. Right? So if you like my explanation, you can like this video, you can subscribe my channel, and you can also press the bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.